So, 1998, Elizabeth, check out the Forrest film, and Love is the Devil, Tom Hanks, incredible work. And then, in short order, you were a shooting star at the Berlin Film Festival. You know, I was wondering if you could remember.
I lost my award that night.
Also very cool.
Great night.
Oh! Can you recall for us what it was like to be that guy on the cusp of this career? What were your thoughts, ambitions, ideas at that point?
It was, it doesn't seem like it doesn't seem that long ago, but that's for sure. It seems like only yesterday. But it was just about working. I had the chance to be able to do this job and earn a living was all I ever really wanted to do. I mean, genuinely, it's like, once you're at drama school, and I went through 3 years of drama school, you come out the other end and you think, first I've got to get a job, and then I've got to keep working. And that's all I ever cared about. And I just got kind of a few really lucky breaks, two of which were Elizabeth and Love is the Devil, working with extraordinary filmmakers. I was very buoyant, but still kind of in a incredibly naive, didn't really know which direction I wanted to go in, except that I wanted to continue doing what I was doing.
So you followed that with a string of remarkable romantic lead characters, but all in these kind of crazy, complex, doomed love stories. I'm thinking of Love is the Devil, of course, the mother, Sylvia. Were you drawn to these kind of doomed, dark lovers?
Like, yes. I mean, quite frankly, I think that the darker side of people's characters is often the most interesting. That doesn't mean, that things don't have to have humor in them, and they can be, but I've always liked a darker sense of humor. And emotion, deep emotion, dark emotion is just something that I suppose I just connected with at that time and was very into the idea of just, I don't know, being moved. There's sort of movies I liked watching, so I thought that's why I wanted to do it. But also, I had the chance to work with these amazing directors, and you just don't turn job like that down.
So you were on your way, you were on this incredible track to be a world-renowned actor. But then, this thing... we were like, more than Mother, please.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, you made a choice. It wasn't just a choice to become a global movie star. It was a choice, I wrote it down here, because the embodiment of a nation, right? Like, this character isn't just Bond. That guy. No, but I mean, I'm just the incredible pressure, not just to like make a career choice, really, but like a whole, like to become this instant icon. What was that like?
Well, it could have gone the other way. I could have not become an instant icon. I fully expected. I knew we had a good movie when we were making it, but I hadn't. I sort of squared it away with myself that if it was a swing and a miss, it was a swing and a miss. And, you can be one movie and then you walk away and go, hey, I tried it. So, somebody else can have to go now. But I push, and I still do to a certain extent, push all that stuff away because I don't really connect to it. I mean, the idea of it, and what's been so nice about something like this and something doing the fifth Bond movie and actually looking back a little bit and actually looking back at what we've done, it's been incredibly emotional because it's massive, and I kind of hadn't realized how big it was. A friend of mine has directed this little movie, little documentary to go with it, which is sort of Barbara Broccoli and Michael Wilson and I talking about the past 50 years. And so I sort of forced to sort of look at it. I rarely look back, and I don't look at past work, I don't look at work I've done, and certainly don't watch movies I've done. But it sort of forced me to do that, and that was, the enormity of it has sort of struck me now more than anything.
actually have a world premiere clip from being James Bond. So this is super special. Please, no recording. You can record when nothing's on the screen. Get those phones away. Person to see. Let's take a quick look at being James Bond.